City officials have been working hard to coordinate efforts all across Sioux Falls.
Now, today, the city command center was set up for the emergency situation unfolding. Our chief photographer, Kevin Kiergaard, brings us an inside look at the response.
It's complicated.
We put it on a roller
boat. I drove over 41st of Minnesota.
And I can grab all of your press releases.
Okay, thanks, Shannon.
Ice chunks. I mean, the flow was crazy.
Basically says the bike trail system is impacted.
Is that dammed up at all by the falls, or is that flowing?
Right there at Yankee Memorial Park. That's going to be a record.
You know, I was just going to kind of get an update of how things are going out there.
We ask people to not go around the barriers and stay away from the water.
I'm looking at concrete now.
This Regan.
We've got barriers everywhere we can put barriers.
And don't drive through it just because there's not a barricade there.
We want them to call what, the non-emergency police number?
If they call, yeah, to Metro.
Okay.
And that'll get us out to evaluate the intersections, and then we can get barricades out there. Well, they got called
so
out to some more stuff, but I haven't seen them add any of them to our list here where they need barricades.
Operator has been recovered from the vehicle and out of the water. EM units can disregard.
And then they're driving around the barricades.
How's the water treatment plant set?
We're currently at 44 million gallons a day.
So at 10:30 briefing, we'll start out with a weather update from National Weather Service. So focus on, remember, where your sump pumps discharge outside and don't do any necessary water usage today.
We got those people.